Whisper Gaming ASMR. In this episode, I will be playing the Diablo 4 open beta once again. I believe this will be episode number 4. And I have almost hit level 12. I see a little white, okay, the little yellow markers, another player. I don't know, Rocky. So let's see, let's open up the map and see what we have to do. This quest cannot be progressed, okay. So it looks like this is the quest I should be doing. Then we also have these different dungeons that unlock new abilities. This one kind of seems good. Let's go to this one and then we'll continue on with the main storyline quests. So yeah, I played this a bit yesterday. I played it pretty late into the night. And I had a revelation after playing it that I know I've been... It's like a... I think I need to turn things down a bit in my monitor. So I've been trying to keep my build very simple. As you can see, I haven't even used my first ability slot yet. I just have right and left click. And it just made me realize how simple this game is. I'm literally just clicking my mouse buttons and picking up and clicking on random gear. And it, let's see, I'll talk a little bit more after I finish this fight. I don't know, kind of made this game feel a little too simplistic how I'm playing it. Since I only have two abilities, I'm literally just right and left clicking and picking up random things, kind of like a slot machine. So yeah, I will try to diversify my build and add a little more complexity during this episode. I guess I am hitting the Q button to trigger my health potions every now and then. And then also trying to avoid some enemy attacks. So I guess there is a slight level of complexity. But besides that, I'm kind of just clicking my mouse over and over. Which is kind of what Diablo is in general, but... I guess as I progress it will get more complex. Okay, so we have hit level 12, I have a new ability. I kind of want to just like try out like a different build. But I am enjoying the werebear. I could do like more of a magic one, but that deal damage, sunder the earth, impaling the first enemy hit for 26. Gathers around your weapon. Let's see. Conjure Swirling Tornado that deals 57 damage. That deals an increase the number of strikes the longer is channeled. Let's see. Powerful Wind surrounds you, granting 20% non-physical damage reduction. The winds rapidly expand, knocking back enemies and dealing 24 damage. That one might be nice. Surround you, granting a barrier. Yeah, let's do this one. That gives me a decent amount of crowd control, I guess. Nice. I have a new button to click. That's just doing the passive ones, because I feel like I'm... Generally in games, I'm really bad at, like... I don't even know if it's the right term, but like attack rotations, I feel like I just panic and mash buttons, so I always opt for passive abilities and things like that because you're going to benefit like hiding. Looks like they might have already completed this event. Okay, well, I don't see anything here. People already completed it. Okay, it disappeared off the map, so I'm assuming it's done. Also going to be sipping some tea later in this episode. I just brewed it, so it needs to cool so I don't completely scald my mouth, but a little teaser to look forward to later in this video. I wanted to do hard candy or gum, but I've been really bad about my intermittent fasting the past few days, and as you can see, it's already almost 10 o'clock, so I don't want to mess up my fast with candy or gum, so I'll only be doing whispering. I also kind of want to do an experiment of what type of videos get the most views, so I don't know if this is the best practice for YouTube, but I'm planning on, I should have at least 4 videos, because it's the 4th one, but I'm uploading all of them at the same time, probably tomorrow night. Maybe Monday night. I'm recording this on a Saturday because I want to do it while the hype of Diablo 4 is still going on. But I'm going to upload all of them at the same time and see which one gets the most views. This dungeon seems pretty sparse with the enemies, but I probably just jinxed that. One out. What does this look like? Okay, nice. There we go. Now we have advantageous strike. Okay, let's see if I can conjure all these guys up and then kill them all with one. this freezing is really fucking me. I need to kite these guys a little bit. Come on, generate some. Uh-oh, I am out of health potions. Someone needs to... There we go. Okay, I gotta kill these shamans. I guess this game isn't too simplistic. There is some thinking to it. Assuming that is him right there, then they'll probably unlock this door. Wow, increased health. I'm like, why is that guy taking so long to kill? There's gonna be an actual boss I need to fight at the end of this too. I wonder if leveling this up, does it give me more spirit each time I level it up? Necromancer's coffin. Return mechanical boxes. So much more damage. Okay. this mod called Cobblemon yesterday, where someone, our team, has implemented Pokemon into Minecraft, which I know has been done before through a mod I think called Pixelmon, but the Pokemon models don't really look like Minecraft. Like, they're like smooth, high definition models, which Cobblemon actually looks like Minecraft art style for all the Pokemon, and they have, I don't know, it seems like from the videos watching comparing the two, they have more quality of life improvements, which I've never played Pixelmon, so I can't attest to that. But I think once I get back from traveling, the week after next, I'm gonna install that on the desktop that I'm playing on right now, and try recording that for some videos, because I have wanted to like add a Pokemon game to the rotation. I've kind of been like wanting to get back into a Pokemon game recently, and it seems like Cobblemon will be a good compromise between Minecraft and Pokemon, so keep an eye out for that. Not sure when that'll get recorded / uploaded, but something on the horizon to look forward to. I think when I knocked that banshee down a couple minutes ago, that made me think of it, because one of the highlights, oh god, don't die here, one of the highlights for Cobblemon is they like have a lot of cool animations. Like if you kill one of the Pokemon with like a sword or an axe, they have unique animations, and some of them have like unique sleeping animations. The video I watched had Golbat, and he like kind of falls down and face plants when he falls asleep. And when I knocked that banshee down in this game, it made me think of that. Okay, Great Shrine, I'm pretty sure that makes, whenever I hit enemies, they drop gold, so I want to have some enemies to hit. Nice. And it makes me faster. Come at me. God, I love knocking. For some reason, that, like, knockdown animation is just very satisfying. As much too, I'm noticing. I wonder if they tweaked that, because there was an update to this game when I launched it today. Where the hell are these mechanical boxes? Combo. glitching in this game than in other, like, the previous Diablos. I could be misremembering, but I don't think you could. I feel like there's less things to dodge. The lethal shrine, what does this do? Oh shit. Might be my least favorite enemy in this game, aesthetically at least. Shrine more than once. Oh, all of your hits are critical strikes, okay, nice. Oh, sick. Why can't I open that? Down, one to go. And I'm almost to lucky level 13. Gateway to learning. Another game I've also kind of been wanting to play randomly, and especially for ASMRs, considering getting back into World of Warcraft. I like periodically get back into it every probably 2 or 3 years. I'll play it for like a month, but was considering that just to see how it's going. But I think I'd have to buy all the expansions and shit, which I don't really want to do. But also kind of interested in checking out WoW Classic, because I did start World of Warcraft along with Diablo 2, were some of the earliest games I played. Surprisingly, it's my grandfather that actually this combo works. But yeah, surprisingly, it's my grandfather that got me into them. The first game he really got me into is EverQuest way, way back in the day. I was very young. Which, I have no idea how I played it, because a couple of years ago, more than a couple of years ago now, probably like 5 years ago or more, I tried playing EverQuest, and I'm like, wow, this is so complicated. Because you have to, like, type in commands to talk to NPCs, and there's just not much direction in the game at all. So I have no idea how I was, like, figuring that out as a 5-year-old. But yeah, so I started out with EverQuest. Then I started playing World of Warcraft way back in the day. Probably right around when Wrath of the Lich King came out. So I used to play it whenever I'd go to visit him, or like I'd spend the night. And he'd always sleep until 8 a.m., which at that age seemed like so late. And now I'm like, oh, 8 a.m.'s like a pretty relatively early time to be up by. I mean, I get up around 6:30. I get up anywhere between 6:30 and like 8 o'clock these days. But anyway, so I used to play it in the mornings before he'd wake up, and then a lot of times I'd like watch him play. So I've kind of wanted to get back, well, try out World of Warcraft Classic, because I haven't tried it out, to see how nostalgic it is. But I don't even know the state of that game yet. Like, I know they went up to the Wrath of the Lich King, and I'm not sure if they... Oh yeah, I can't remember if Burning Crusades, maybe it's Burning Crusades and Wrath of the Lich King. Maybe Burning Crusades is when I start playing. But I don't know how far they're gonna take that. Cataclysm was the point where I got my own World of Warcraft account. I was in high school when that happened, when that came out. And, okay, this is what I need right here. So, Cataclysm, around that time is when I played the most World of Warcraft. I never got, like, super into it. I think I got one character. I got a paladin up to max level during Cataclysm, but I never really did any raids. I think I've done one raid total, and that was when they had some type of, like, anniversary event, and I got some burning crown or something. And I did not carry my weight in that raid at all. But yeah, so WoW Classic is something that I've been wanting to try out for a while, so I might bite the bullet and try that out for ASMR, but we'll see. I have a lot of things on my list that I'll probably get to before that, which I mentioned in a previous Diablo video, but I'm gonna probably do Grand Theft Auto 5 online, or yeah, I'll try online. If I don't like it, I'll do single player. But I'll probably try that pretty soon. Gonna keep more Minecraft videos coming. I wanna re-record Slime Rancher still. Definitely down to play more Deep Rock Galactic, since I just really enjoy that game, and hopefully you will enjoy watching it. It's such a good game, and I don't know, the community is so good, and I just really enjoy it. And there's a lot of new content I haven't explored. And then I really gotta get back to Metroid, because I haven't played that in probably going on a month now. I still have, I think, 3 more videos from Metroid to upload that I recorded quite a while ago. And then also Stardew Valley, since I haven't played that in definitely close to a month. It's also going to be kind of hard. I'm going to be very rusty when I go back to some of these games. Like, I can't really remember what I was doing in Stardew Valley. Metroid controls are going to be... I'm going to need a little refresher on those. back to them. There's definitely still a lot of processes that I need to work on for building this channel. So let's see if this tea is drinkable or if you're gonna hear me burn my mouth live on camera. This texture, they really phoned it in on whatever that's supposed to be. That does not look very good. Playing this also makes me tempted to go back to Diablo 3 and potentially Diablo 2 Remastered. I don't have Diablo 2 Remastered, so I probably won't spend the money to buy that, but that would be really nostalgic. I spent so much time in that game. I do wonder how it'd hold up, because I think there's a lot of quality of life improvements that the more modern games have that I would miss, but that was part of that game's charm. Was the difficulty. Oh. Also what? Turn, okay. That just increases maximum spirit, so that's the one I need. And I cannot use that rare bow. That's Rogue was a thing. I think Rogue was replaced by Assassin. Or was it Demon Hunter? I don't know. I can't even keep track of the classes between Diablo 2 and Diablo 3. Surgery the other day, well, yesterday. So she had to go into work really early yesterday and then came home early from work and had a few hours to like get some sleep and then had to work overnight last night. So that's why I was recording videos so late last night, and then she didn't get home until like 8 a.m. So I tried to stay up to kind of match her sleep schedule, and we didn't wake up until almost noon today. So this weekend's been a bit of a wash. I haven't had as much time to play music as I would have hoped. But when I do get the chance, I've been trying to play a lot. I've been playing a lot of 12-string guitar, because I just got... Let's see, I might need to focus on this light. Fight, and then I'll get back to my use the space bar. I've not been using evade much at all. I need more spirit. Okay, so I think those little triangles, when I break those, I think that means that the boss is gonna drop health potions. Is what I'm gathering. Oh no. I don't like how those heads like now. Moving around after, like, I dodge them, they still continue to chase me. Someone drop a freaking health potion. Knock him down. Okay, there we go. Come on, come on. And of course he's like backed against a wall, so I can't even get behind him. I said about this game being too simple. I knew I was gonna regret saying that. Do I have to start from the beginning. Okay, I need to like rethink my abilities here. Which one's this? Oh, wear bare form. My heart is like pounding. Oh, boy, oh god, I have this, okay. Fuck that. Summon to the bite. These are like my favorite things, was having the summons. The enemies in the area. Fuck yes, these are my favorite. There we go. Now those. See how this goes now. Actually, that's scary. I don't even use that much. Can I have more than one companion? Where's my raven? No, actually. Supplies. Yeah, let's go with that. Yeah, back in the day when I played druid, I just had like an army of animals with me. So, okay. Maybe this will go better now. We shall see. It's annoying that I have to start all over. If my wolves die, though. Can't tell if this is going better or not. And that globe disappeared, goddammit. I didn't think they had a time limit. faster. Just teleported it down. Save myself a load screen. I think I'll go back to town. Sell some stuff. Oh, let's do this world event. And then probably end this video there. Is there an event going on here? Event joined. Ancient obelisk. Stand on the points to satiate the obelisk. This would be a lot better with other people. Nice. Got my boy Taco with me. That's getting siphoned out right now. Okay, let's get this last one. Nice. Slay the remaining enemies. That's easy enough. Resistance, shatter resistance, cold resistance. That'd be pretty good, since cold is super annoying. this down. God, this gets like a little laggy when you go into town. Oh, God, I was gonna crash there for a second. Salvage that stuff so I can get some new transmogs. Yeah, I'll keep that virtual. Not that it matters, this all resets in like a day and a half. Tomorrow's probably the last day I'll actually have time to play it, so I guess my transmogs don't matter too much. This icon there, what? Do I have something new? I guess it's the silver ore. Well, got a little bit accomplished in that. Hit two more levels and added some things to the hotbar and proved this game is a little more complicated than I thought. It's not too simplistic. Oh, let's check out the alchemist. Is there anything new I can buy there? I would like to be able to get some more health potion charges. That'd be nice. I have to hit level 20 before I can upgrade that. Can craft an elixir at 1,000. Said something about I need like renown to unlock more charges, but I don't know how that works. I do wonder what these health potions are made of. I feel like they just seem like a thing of blood, but whatever. Weird way to end this video, but as always, I hope you've enjoyed this. If you're trying to fall asleep, I hope you're not hearing this because you're already asleep. And I just appreciate you spending your time with me and making it to this point in the video. If you liked it, please like. If you want to see more, I would love a subscribe. It'd really mean a lot to me. And I love to hear your comments and feedback. They really do mean the world to me. It's just nice to know that people are enjoying my videos or hearing ways I can improve them. So thank you so much, and I hope to see you again soon. Good night and goodbye.